Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today we're going to show a combo brow lift, some of the pitfalls, and what we can do to avoid it. So the brow lift is often misunderstood, and patients don't know exactly where we inject for a lift, and they'll often point to the forehead region where their other injector injected to get the lift. And it's hard to know when you're sitting in the chair and you're the patient where the injections were, the way the nerves are. It feels like you might be injected in one area and it's totally different. So it's understandable. One of the pitfalls of the forehead, injecting it, people want a smooth forehead, and injecting the forehead lowers the eyes, and the lines to become smooth then create the problem, especially the ones above the brow where everyone points to, because it's a hallmark that someone's had toxin in their forehead and the injector correctly didn't treat those lines. So here what we're doing, we're doing Dysport today, we're doing the Dysport injections in the forehead with a fairly conservative pattern, often a V pattern with a couple of injection points with lighter dose above the brow region. We also inject lateral to the brow at the downward fibers of the orbicularis oculi, and that helps to create the traditional brow lift. Here we're putting smooth PDO threads in above the brow, and this is a marathon, not a sprint, and so while you get an immediate effect, the reason I'm doing it is for the long-term collagen building above the brow. Over time, these lines will fade away. I often repeat these smooth threads, and when the lines go away, we don't need to add toxin here, and even though they're smooth, they're not barbed, that collagen does indeed create lift. In this country, we always think about barbed threads as creating all the lift, but smooth threads do indeed create some lift with tightening and that collagen production. And the idea is we aren't going to need to dose above the brow where we create that droop very much in the future, if at all. I start with a 30 gauge smooth if the patient's new to threads, but really what we want is a twist, 1 inch, 1.5 inches. It's a little long to navigate in this region, but you can use it if the forehead is wider. And I use this here in a layer of about 3. So stack about 3 on top of each other going up the forehead region. And remember, for filler in this area, it can be done. However, there's a risk of necrosis. This is the area that's fraught with problems because of intra-arterial injections is quite vascular. So the threads don't have that risk of necrosis. So adding the threads to smooth the area above the brow so we don't have to use toxin that can lower is a great combination treatment. Try and do it on all my patients, especially those with deep lines that are just above the brow, because at a certain point you won't be able to treat it. As the eye ages, the lid gets redundant, the skin increases, they'll feel that droop. Thanks for joining me today. Add your comments below. What do you do for a brow lift and to treat a droopy eye with toxin? And let me know, follow us on Instagram and Facebook also for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.